Hello everyone, Simus here, and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved. So you might notice things are a little bit different right now. This is not my single player, nor is this the server that I play on. We are currently being hosted by my good friend Abby here, and we are basically going to do some Ark science today. I just figured I would go ahead and record a little bit of that just because we can. So what this is we're basically messing around on her single player technically. These are just some more prototype builds. Yes, this is very crappy and poorly lined up building. That is because it is a rough sketch of something that I was messing around with. And essentially, don't expect the actual design to look like that if I do decide to do it. And ignore all the random things you see around here. Because sometimes when you're building and doing a lot of stuff, you get a little bit bored and start doing shenanigans. So today, we are making a color wall to determine what the best color is on stone. Specifically, stone walls. Because you have eyes and you can determine this for yourself. Yes, I know there's a color wall on the Ark Wiki. I have seen it for myself. However, if you have ever seen the color wall screenshots posted on the wiki, you will notice that they have a super huge gigantic flaw. And that's that those screenshots were taken and uploaded by someone who was using Gamma, and they left their Gamma up for all of the screenshots, including the ones taken during the day. The problem with Gamma is that, while it does help you see at night, it has this awful habit of washing the colors out very badly, so you can't actually see them like their true colors. So we decided we were going to make our very own color wall in order to see for ourselves. So you guys get to see it too, just because I am bored and have nothing else to do but make more videos than I had actually intended to make. And these are some of our other random things. I haven't actually shared this yet, and this definitely needs some work. It's not actually the correct color, but this is our basic new tribe emblem that we will be using in the future. For now, we are going to need to spawn some stuff in. I know we have some dyes, but I don't know which ones. Actually, I think Abby's gonna do at least some of the coloring, if not most of it, because I don't know what dyes she has. And let's see. I also may be tabbing in and out to actually get the IDs to spawn in the dyes. I can spawn stuff in here because I have been given permission. Oh yeah, and so you can see the pillars I had in my last video were marking out the basic area of Abby's base, which is this. And as you can see, she also marked out where my base is going to be, approximately, so that we do not actually build on top of each other, which, as I mentioned in the last video, we accidentally almost did, but there's plenty of room between us. Let's go ahead, and I'm going to tab out very quickly and get the first set of dye IDs because it is impossible to remember all of them off the cuff, so BRB. Alright, that was actually pretty easy because I had the page up already. And let's see. Oh, I need a paintbrush, don't I? I believe I still have one here from yesterday when we were fooling around. Yes, that is an extremely high level argent. Look at the stats on this thing. Oh, it's actually... the stats aren't crazy OP like they were yesterday. Apparently the argent got nerfed. But I know for a fact there is a paintbrush in here, and we are going to make full use of it. Ignore the fact that there's a large number of random stuff just everywhere. That's just sometimes when you want to build. I'm not actually sure if Abby's AFK or not. Alright, so we are gonna go ahead and make our first set of dice. D8 is red. 59. We're basically going to go through 68 and spawn all of these in. Some of these are going to be annoying because I don't think they're all in the ID arrays, so some of them you actually have to do the file path manually. But we shall see. I think I already had white, but I don't really care that much. And we may not actually end up needing these since it looks like Abby is just going to town already. Which is fine. I have them if needed. So this is... that looks like red. But yeah, if you were to pause this video and compare the screenshot of this wall with the one in the wiki, the one on the wiki is very obviously with the gamma turned up, which means it's actually useless as a real reference. I keep hoping it's something that they'll fix, but they never do. So that is green, that is blue, that is yellow, that is purple, and orange, and black. And white. And brown. So yes, I did just waste like the last 2 minutes. That's okay. Cyan, one of my favorite colors. Fun fact, if you haven't been playing Ark for as long as I have, which is probably most of you because I am a little overly attached to this game, cyan was not one of the original dye colors. Well, it was and it wasn't. They were actually using this as a test dye for things, and people saw it in their things, and it was so popular that people kept begging for them to put it in the game. And it took them absolutely forever, but they finally did, and I, for one, am extremely happy that they did, because I use it all the time. So we've got... let's see, cyan. That might actually be royalty versus purple. That's silver, that's sky, that is parchment. I'm trying to remember all the color names off the top of my head. I can't remember all of them. See, that is a... I think that one's olive. That one's not yellow. Oh, is it? Oh, there's pink. Alright, so one of these is silver and one of them is sky. I can't actually tell which one is which. Ignore the fact that neither of us is actually wearing any form of armor. When you're in god mode, you don't actually need armor, and considering that we keep accidentally dying and whatnot, well, I should say I was accidentally dying. So if you're doing a dedicated server, spectate mode, you will actually still be tethered and drag the other person around and teleport them randomly into the sky so that they fall down and die. True story. Don't ask how I know this. Not sure why we're destroying those. Is that all of them? I don't see. I guess... Hey, I just found something funny. So purple is actually in the ID array twice. It's number 62 and 68, which is why I was so confused. That's actually kind of funny. You know, I think stone actually picks up color really well. Metal looks terrible on half of them, which is really unfortunate when you have a metal base that won't look good no matter what you do. Which is one of the reasons why I really enjoy this new project where we're going to be building in things that aren't metal, besides the fact that farming paste is a pain in the butt. Let's see, where's Navy? I think Navy's one of these ones at the top. Actually, I'm not sure why I'm not just flying around myself, given that I have the capability. There we go. So now we can actually see what we're doing. You can probably hear my typing noises, for which I apologize. There's not a lot I can do about that until I am able to get a better microphone. I'm using a really cheap headset that you've probably noticed picks up a lot of things that I don't want it to pick up. Sand looks pretty good. I'm really heavily biased towards it anyways, to be honest, they really do all look good. My house is probably gonna end up being like white stone. Maybe. Trying to figure out which one is navy. Technically, our official tribe colors are white and any shade of blue. I think this one's navy actually. Is it this one? This is either navy or royalty. My problem with the blues in Ark is that they end up looking purple a lot for some reason. I mean, purple's a fine color and all, but when you actually want blue, it's a bit of a pain. Or maybe Abby just left navy off. I think that one's navy. So is that one? Is this navy? Darned if I know. This is really such a bad angle for looking at stuff. We really should have been facing like east or west, not whatever direction this is. I can't actually see the sun right now. There it is. Trying to think of what would go good with the colors because we're also running the idea for the plan is that we're going to use primarily the blue lighting that you get from angler gel because, well, I like it basically. Apparently we're just using this as like a reference. So yeah, we're just really excited to be basically getting together and tribing. We've already got at least 5 people to be in our tribe. There will probably be more. I'm not sure how many people are going to be joining, but I am going to be starting a tribe, so this is all just preparation for that. Everyone wants to join up and hang out and just have a lot of fun together is really what it comes down to. That's why I was doing this. This is supposed to be, first of all, it's gonna be a pain in the butt. God, those things are creepy. This was a pain in the butt to do, because of the sheer amount of resources, and it will look considerably better in the real version. But I wanted to make like a little town square where we can gather and have like events and stuff. And this was supposed to be a stage. As you can see, there were some technical failures on my part. But since we're not actually going to be necessarily building exactly the way things are here, I was not that concerned with it. I just wanted an idea of how it would look. Because when you start out building, like, I don't know how other people do it, but I'll either have a design in mind or a specific thing that I want to do. Other times, I won't have any ideas whatsoever and I'll just start doing stuff. That was what happened with the square. And why I went with the double railings where one's stone and one's wood. That was me just creating, I guess you could say. I'm far from the best builder in this game, but I like to spend time just experimenting and doing things. I do spend a lot of time building, as much as I like doing like the animal taming and whatnot and all those shenanigans. I found I really do enjoy building quite a bit. And yes, that is the time of day being changed, in case you're wondering. Ooh, that's really creepy. I like that. You can't actually tell how things look with the colors on it, but so much creeptastic. This is why I really like the angler gel, because it looks so incredibly creepy. Because it's just got like that ghostly quality to it. And this is why I heavily support using single player to work all this stuff out. Because you just never know. Also, I'm not really sure why that obelisk looks yellow when it's supposed to be green. Maybe it's the lighting. Ha ha ha. I'm sorry. I'm in a weird mood right now. Not gonna lie, the light looks more like white than blue. So the way it's reflecting, it honestly look really does look good. case you're wondering why I'm typing and not speaking, Abby doesn't have a mic that she can use, and I'd rather just use text. Besides, you all hear me yapping often enough as it is, right? This looks really cool. Potato arc is best arc. Not really. This isn't really a potato, but it's definitely not like I'm using Titans or anything. Just saying. Yeah, that's like the biggest thing about using Arc on lower settings is that it does weird things to like the color, and I think if you have like skies and stuff. Sky looks good. That looks good too. Not so sure about that one. Gonna lie, they really do. I'm just gonna punch the wall for emphasis. Oh no, I made a fist mark. Oh, there goes the fist mark. The wall repaired itself. Yes, it is very important to be choosing colors and things. You never know. I'm not sure if I would do an entire base in one color. I did that for my metal base just to cut down on the glare because people were constantly complaining about it. I, of course, never noticed because I always turn bloom quality off. Nice mix of blues, that would be nice. And purple, blue and purple. Oops. Look, we just solved world hunger. Actually, while I'm here, I'm gonna turn this on in case some other shenanigans. actually died from spawning, getting dragged across the map from teleporting, and then I landed in the swamp and bad things happened, and that's how I died. So I'm just gonna keep God on for a while, just in case. You never know. I wonder if you can actually color the backside of the walls. Do I actually have? I do have dye on me. Let's check. I just wanna see. Whoa. I did not really intend to spin that. There we go. Interesting. You can't actually paint the wood, I don't think. I'm not actually sure what Abby's doing on that side. Bottom one's green. Alright, so now let's get the green. I just want to see what it looks like from the back. Spray painting is fun. These are the kinds of decisions that keep me up at night. Okay, so the wood does kind of paint. It just. Oh, I see, because the foundation was kind of blocking it a little bit. I don't know. There are a lot of weird things that happen in Ark, so you learn kind of to just roll with it. Oh, here's a fun fact that I learned last night while I was messing around. If you put angler gel in a campfire, it does not actually turn blue, which is extremely disappointing. So yeah, it glows red like everything else. I'm not sure if that's just an oversight on the dev's part or intended. 50-50, really. So yeah. If you were to pause this video right here, you can very, very clearly see that the colors are way darker than what they look like on the wiki. And that is because these are accurate in-game colors. So I guess now we're just playing around, messing with it. Anyways, I think we're about done messing around with the paints for the most part. I think. So, I think that's gonna be about it for this video. I just thought it was something interesting enough to warrant recording because, as I've mentioned multiple times, the wiki's not accurate for colors on stone, and we wanted to get a look at what they actually look like, so we figured we would just go ahead and do it ourselves. And since we're doing that, now you get to see it for yourself. Actually, can I turn that off? There we go. So there you go, an unvarnished look of the color walls. Oh, let's see what this, what's, we're being requested to look at first before we go. Looks pretty nice actually. wood's not very black. Anyways, we're going to continue basically hashing all this out. Thank you all for joining me, and I will see you all in the next episode.